beautiful Wednesday. It's Wednesday because we're on our way, Coco and I, to do team training. We're going to be talking about the top takeaways that we got from Tom Ferry Summit, which was incredible as always. How I'm going to narrow it down to an hour, I don't know, but we'll manage somehow or another. Hey, there goes my kid. Savannah's finally back after being away 2 weeks in Europe. Lucky duck. So today's topic is be careful what you wish for. So some of you, if you follow, are realizing that Wes and I are doing Bible study every morning. We do about 20 minutes of an audio version of the Bible, and we follow along. And we're in Numbers. So we've been reading, and the children of Israel are out wandering in the wilderness. And of course, God agrees to provide for their needs. So he's going to provide them food. So he gives them manna to eat, which is like a coriander seed, it says. And it says it had the taste of olive oil, and they could crush it and make it into different things. Well, it didn't take long, and those Israelites started complaining about that manna because that's all they had to eat. Now, you need to know this about me. I am what you would consider not a picky eater at all. I have no use for picky eaters. I give picky eaters a hard time. Some of my dearest friends are picky eaters, and I give them grief about it. They know this. So I am not about picky eating. But, every time I read this, I think, I feel bad because I'm like, I know I would be complaining about manna if I was still having it for so long, right? If I had one thing to eat all the time. Because here we are all struggling to get on a diet, and we know good and well all we got to do is eat this, and not that, and we can have all the food we want and still lose weight. Do we do it? No. So I know I'd be griping about that manna. So sure enough, I like to think I wouldn't, but I got to be straight up with you. I don't know that I'd be happy with manna on day 72 or 150, whatever it was at that point. So they're asking and they're going, why did you bring us out here to eat this food, God? At least we had, it said, garlic and onions and cucumbers back in Egypt. Now, they were slaves, but they were going to go back and be slaves again as long as they could get some of that good food to eat. And if you've ever been hungry, you know what I'm talking about, right? They're like, God, why'd you bring us in the wilderness just to make us starve with just this manna to eat day and night? We detest this manna. So you know what God said to him? He said, you want meat? You want meat? I'm going to give you some meat. He said, I'm going to send you meat, and it's going to be stuck in your teeth. He said, and you are going to eat meat till it comes out your nostrils. God told him, you're going to eat meat till it comes out your nostrils. That's a lot of meat, let me tell you. So for 30 days, from what I understand, there was no manna going on. It was just the quail. 30 days of nothing but quail, and God said, kind of one of those, I'm going to shove this meat down your throat kind of things. If you want quail, I give you quail. And I feel so much like, what are we not being grateful for that we have? They weren't having to work. They were just going out and picking up manna. It said it was as plentiful as the dew on the ground, just crispy, thin flakes, and they were picking it up, but it wasn't good enough. So then they wanted the quail. And then they questioned, how are you going to give enough quail for 650,000 men plus all these other people? And God said, basically, have you met me? Do you know who you're talking to? Do you not think, after everything I've done and the miracles you've seen, that I can provide this? So that's when he said, I'm going to give you meat stuck in your teeth and coming out your nostrils. So the lesson I take away from this is, number one, don't be a complainer. And I fear that I would have been a complainer in this situation. And number two, be grateful for what you had. It obviously was no effort whatsoever for him to give them that quail. It wasn't the fact that they wanted the quail. It had to be the ingratitude, the lack of gratitude that they showed for what they did have and what he gave them by his kind, benevolent hand. So today, I want to make sure, if nothing else, I'm going to be grateful for what I have, because I do not want quail coming out my nostrils. That and metaphorically, that is right. So be careful what you ask for. Ask for what it is you need for your family. Ask for great and abundant blessings, but most importantly, be grateful for the ones you already have, and everything's going to be good. We got a big team meeting to go wrap up Tom Ferry Summit today, so I got to head into training. And so Coco wants to say, check y'all later. Everybody wondering where Frankie is. He's riding in with Dad today. So bye, Beansies. See y'all later. Bye.